WCVH proudly presents CV Today.
Good afternoon. Today is Monday, January 3rd.
Now over to Jillian with some more announcements.
What's up, CV? Glad to see you back from break. January 3rd, the low today is gonna be a 23, the high is gonna be 37, and maybe just a little chance of snow, you don't know, just maybe a little chance. So, over to headline news.
The U.S. is facing a dangerous surge in hospitalizations due to a wave of new coronavirus cases. That's according to the top U.S. infectious diseases expert, Dr. Anthony Fauci, who on Sunday told ABC News that even if symptoms of the Omicron variant seem less severe, the sheer numbers created a risk.
Even if you have a less of a percentage of severity, when you have multi-fold more people getting infected, the net amount is you're still going to get a lot of people that are going to be needing hospitalization. And that's the reason why we're concerned about stressing and straining the hospital system.
The sudden arrival of Omicron has brought record-setting case counts to countries around the world and dampened New Year festivities across the globe. According to data from the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the Omicron variant was estimated to cause almost 60% of coronavirus infections circulating in the United States as of December 25th. U.S. authorities registered almost 347,000 new coronavirus cases on Saturday, according to a Reuters tally. The U.S. death toll from the pandemic is approaching 830,000, the highest of any country on the planet.
Keystone exams will take place this week, Wednesday, January 5th to Friday, January 7th. If you are not required to take a Keystone exam, you do not have to report to school and instead log on to Schoology. Now over to Money with Mead.
Hello, welcome to Mellow Yellow Monday. We're all wearing yellow here, sorry. Anyway, this is Ms. Mead with Money with Mead, and I'm talking to juniors and seniors. Yes, juniors and seniors, this is your week. Juniors, remember you have until Wednesday to fill out your applications for Rotary Student of the Month. Remember, it switched up on me, and so I need them done ASAP, and this is for February and March, okay? So, juniors, check your emails, also check your Schoology page. It's posted, and apply. Seniors, you've been waiting. I know. You've been waiting 4 long years to do this, actually 3.5. 3.5 years to fill out your senior award sheet. The time has come. So, you can check your emails, you can also check your Schoology page, you can also check the Money With Me Schoology page. It will be posted there. And what you need to do is you need to plan aside 30 minutes to an hour to fill this out. I know you're like, oh my God, this is me. However, you can do it. Plus, some of you have 3 days off coming up. Huh, quinkadink. Anyway, you will have until February 11th. Yes, I said it correctly, February 11th. So that's why I'm giving you all this time. Please don't tell me on February 11th, I didn't have time to do it. Honeys, you've got like 6 weeks to do it. You can do it, I promise. Anyway, make sure you have your list ready of everything you've done from freshman year all the way to high school, I mean, your senior year. Have that ready. And even if you don't have a lot of stuff, please fill it out. The only way you are able to get a scholarship or an award is if you fill out the senior award sheet. So even if you didn't do any activities, please fill it out. And CTC people, if you ever hear this, you need to fill it out too. So please spread the word, and I guess I'll see you next week. Bye!
Attention seniors and juniors, if you would like to be an anchor for the CV Today show during this school year, please stop by the TV studio, room 153, to sign up. All anchors must sign up as a pair of students, and both must be seniors or juniors during the 2021 to 2022 school year.
Stop. sports for today. Now over to sports highlights.
He's out once again with Gibson on 3rd and 3. Heineke airs it out. What a catch inside the red zone. And off to Patterson. Patterson inside the 5. Patterson touchdown. In the league this year. Another catch made. Terry McLaurin streaking down. 3rd and 8 now. Heineke over the middle. And it's Cotton. He's also the holder. And on 1st and 10, Hurts with a pump, now flushed. Throwing on the run, Goddard has it caught, complete. And he's down inside the 5. 1st and goal for Philadelphia. Hurts to pass on 3rd and goal. Hurts back of the end zone, incomplete. On 4th and goal, the give up the middle, Boxer. Able to escape. Heineke eyes downfield, zips it to the end zone, and it's incomplete. Another attempt coming for Sly. Hit from 31 earlier. Long for Sly, kicking for his 3rd team this year. 4th different kicker for Washington. And Sly swings his foot into it, and Sly is good. We're on 4th and goal earlier. Hurts is tripped, flips, dive, touchdown Boston Scott. His 2nd today. Career year. And from 42, he's good to extend the Philadelphia lead. And Elliott is good again. So far, so good. Sweat a couple of sacks, a couple of deflections here on 3rd and 10. Heineke finds Bates, is tied in, and he's able to spin forward right on top of the line to gain. Out of the backfield, Patterson inside of Philly territory. T.J. Edwards with the tackle.
Angles getting to running back.
Complete to Sims. Sims has a 1st down catch and run. 3rd and 5 now. Again, Patterson out of the backfield has a 1st down to the 20. 1st and 10 from the 20. Heineke looking end zone, and it is intercepted by Rodney McLeod.
That's all the announcements we have for you today.
On behalf of WCVH, I'm Summer.
Alongside Veronica, and this is CV Today.
Have a magical Monday.